Such a beautiful expansion of Krishna's own form, Srimati Radharani, who is actually the chief supreme goddess of all goddesses, one who is bestower of service to all the living entities, one who is the supreme mother, universal mother, Jagatera Mata, it is a Jagan Mata, mother of all the jivas. So she appeared today as the little beautiful golden daughter of Vrishabhanu and Kirtida. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida were Suchandra and Kalavati in their previous lives. They also performed penances just like Devaki and Vasudeva performed, eating only dry leaves for 10,000 years. So they also had performed very severe penances. But their desire was to get Goddess of Fortune as their daughter. So on this particular day, Brahma personally appeared in a particular lake when Vrishabhanu went one morning to Yamuna. He saw in Yamuna a beautiful shining golden lotus. And in that golden lotus was lying a beautiful little baby girl who had a golden complexion. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida always had a desire to have a child. And when as soon as Vrishabhanu saw the child, Brahma came down and picked up the child and handed over to Vrishabhanu and told that she will be your child now. You had an aspiration to have Goddess of Fortune as your child. So Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, they were simultaneously happy and unhappy. Why? They were happy that now they got a daughter of their choice, but they were unhappy that the daughter wouldn't open her eyes. So one time Narada Muni, when he came to know Krishna has appeared in this world, 15 days later Radharani appears. So he thought that because Lord has appeared, naturally Goddess of Fortune must have appeared also somewhere. So he searched all over Vraja, everywhere. At last he went to the home of Vrishabhanu and he was curious to ask him whether you got a daughter. When he asked about his children, he just brought Sri Rama and introduced Sri Rama to Narada. So Narada touched Sri Rama's head and blessed him that you will become a great associate of Krishna. He blessed him. And then Vrishabhanu very reluctantly told him that I also have got a daughter, but I am very hesitant to introduce you to her because this child is blind, she is not opening her eyes. So then Narada was very eager, please take me. So when he was taken inside, Narada told Vrishabhanu, you may be very busy with household chores. I don't want to disturb you. You carry on, you know, I will see your child. So after he went away, Narada circumambulated the child several times and he fell at her feet crying tears, that because as soon as he saw Goddess of Fortune, he could recognize. And Radharani also reciprocated by immediately showing her Kaishori form, along with her Lalita, Vishaka and all other associates. They all manifested. After seeing her in that form, again he fainted unconscious. And offered many, many, many Sanskrit poetry, prayers, circumambulating her several times. And he had tears in his eyes. When he came out, Vrishabhanu was wondering, why is he crying? This great sage, the great Narada couldn't tell him anything, any words. But later on, Radharani opened her eyes for the first time when Yashoda, Nanda and Krishna came to their house. When Krishna lifted himself up to see in the cradle, for the first time, at that time Radharani opened her eyes. Which teaches all of us a very important lesson. Use your eyes only to see Krishna. Don't see cinema posters. Don't see useless movies. Use only our eyes to see Krishna. That is Radharani. Wherever she sees only Krishna only, everywhere. It's called Devi Krishnamayi Prokta. Krishnamayi means she is Krishnamaya always.